people living in towns build summer houses and they want to attract storks. Elderly people in villages are no longer able to take care of stork nests, which have consequently become dangerous for roofs and buildings.
The platform should be made in advance, usually from boards. Previously, cartwheels were often used, not because storks particularly liked them, but because they were available in any farmstead and were of the right size and shape. Platform may be square, triangular or round, whichever one can make, but it should be not less than 1 meter in diameter, preferably 1.5 meter. Having installed the platform, you should put some branches in, so that the stork has something to stand on and can start building the nest. Finally, you should put some green moss or some soil onto the branches and can start anticipating storks to occupy the platform. I recommend installing the platform on a pole, not in the yard of a farmstead, but in some distance from it, so that you can still see the nest through the window. Thus, the birds are less disturbed, while branches and droppings of birds, as well as chirps of fledglings, do not disturb you.
Thank you.
The stork is a good indicator of the quality of the environment, especially of the state of agriculture. If agriculture is not too intensive and chemicals are not widely used, such agriculture is suitable for white storks, which is reflected in their abundant population. If the agriculture is too specialized, too intensive, stork populations start to decline. There are a lot of such examples. In the past, population of white storks in Denmark used to be abundant, but now, after some time of complete extinction, there are only several pairs breeding there. Similar situation is in the Netherlands, where agriculture is most intensive. Small-scale farming provides white storks with more mosaic environment, where farmers are engaged in diverse farming activities. Some produce vegetables, others grow sheep, goats, keep horses, cows, or make hay. Not long ago, a flock of crows used to follow the plowing tractor, whereas now there are storks and gulls. There are still some crows, of course. If one keeps cattle, he inevitably has to make hay to maintain natural surroundings. Today the cattle have almost disappeared. In fact, you can count them on your fingers. There used to be meadows around here, and in the early spring it seemed as if a large farm had opened its door and a huge herd of cattle had gone out through the door. There used to be many cows here. Now when you drive across the countryside, the situation is completely different. The fields are nice, the crops are healthy, but there are no cattle. We have analyzed the statistics, which shows that the area of pastures has decreased by the area occupied by the city of Vilnius. Of course, the statistics may be interpreted differently, but the trend is clear. Meadows and pastures are disappearing. At the same time, new meadows and pastures appear, which are naturally more convenient for farmers. The first to disappear and overgrow with bushes are the meadows that are difficult to reach. Water meadows in river valleys, as well as floodplains. From the point of view of biological diversity, they are most valuable. A farmer lives nearby, and he is constantly using fertilizers. As a result, frogs disappear and bees die as well. My neighbor brought some hives from a nixche, but bees could not survive. The fields are treated with chemicals. The bees have no food and no place to gather the nectar. There are lots of storks in our environment at present. Thus, we can state that our agriculture provides products of good quality, which is acceptable to people, and the abundance of storks, which is important as a kind of trademark. Hopefully, such a trend continues in the future. Due to their greed, people started to interfere with nature, and the climate change is the result of the anthropogenic impact. It has gone too far. Earlier, we used to talk about the influence of the land drainage, fragmentation of forests, agricultural activities, but now it is the climate change that has started to influence our environment.
Ar prisidėjo dar kitas ir klimato kaitos poveikis, klimato šiltėjimas, kuris šiauriniam pusėje.
The climate warming, which is more expressed in the northern hemisphere, influences the life of all birds, including the white stork, indirectly through its habitat and its food resources.
Ir jų pokyčius ir per mitybinę bazę. Gandras yra įdomiai tokioj padėti, kad atskiruose mūsų čia regiono aplinkinėse.
The white stork is in a peculiar situation. There are contradictory data from neighboring regions. To some places, the stork returns earlier in spring, elsewhere, let's say Poland, later. And this fact has not been fully investigated. The return of migrating birds, when it is not harmonized with the other processes in nature, may cause problems. Spring and summer start earlier, and the need to feed the brood may not coincide with the peak of food abundance. People in the countryside used to know exactly when white storks returned, how many brood they had, and what they fed on. The young generation needs to be informed and taught about this bird. Although this species is protected, it is disappearing in countries with intensive agriculture. Agriculture in our country is becoming more intensive, and the future for this bird is also not clear and may not be favorable. Therefore, we need to think about the protection of this species. Ornithologists understand this.
Lietuvoje iš tikro prasminga turėti ir baltojo gandro.
In Lithuania, there is a need to have a comprehensive species management plan for the population of the white stork. It may seem a little bit unusual and too drastic to manage such a species, but in practice, the management means the division of activities. Some things have to be left for the nature, and other things would be ascribed to be done by people. We don't intend any special measures for the protection of the white stork, because there is no danger of it becoming entirely extinct. However, its way of life prompts us to take some measures in order to protect both the nest sites of the white stork and its nearest neighbor.